to Skyrim Special Edition. We are right where we left off, actually. Lots of things have happened. We've managed to get all the pieces of armour, this immaculate armour set, which apparently protects us from radiation, which I believe is what was killing us in the tunnels when we went down there. We did so by killing Rikus and stealing his armour, which set off the Dwarves' Law, which we survived by going back to the lighthouse and going back in time. So it's good to know that if we do set it off again, we can survive by doing that. We're going to go into the tunnels now and find out what on earth is going on down here. I'm actually going to purposely not hit candlelight because I want to stay hidden. That will actually help enemies detect you. We'll get the bow out just in case. So last time we were down here, we found this body. I wonder if it will have the helmet on it again. Be interesting if it doesn't. It doesn't look like it does because it was situated like right there. Okay, that's fine. Leandris's corpse. Do we know who Leandris is, actually? Is Leandris in our book? Where is it? Is it just an arrival log? Leandris. Leandris deceased. City Vigilant Vigilant of Stendar died searching underground tunnels. Ask Yormar to bar the door tunnel and post a notice against further expeditions. Okay. So we know why Leandris died, because of the radiation, or quote unquote radiation, that went on down here. Now, when we got about this far, we started taking damage last time. Strange energy radiates all around you. Okay. Appears to be some sort of wisp. We're going to assume that it is not very nice. Magic anomaly. Yeah, I think we can assume that it is not very nice. It basically looks like a frost wisp. No, that please. Okay, it looks like there's a couple of them down there. Is this place? Okie dokie. Do these drop anything? They drop a soul gem. I'll take the ore. Why not? Dwarven oil. That's a alchemy component. I know that much. Or at least Vass would know that much. It's interesting that, like, the dwarves, they're called the dwarves in Skyrim, but they're not actually dwarves, are they? Because their armour fits normal people, so they're not like the, you know, Tolkien-style dwarves, or, you know, that type of thing. I wonder if flames would work on these guys, because that would be a lot easier for me to... Maybe sparks would be better, actually. Just drop a save. I don't know how tough these guys are. I mean, we've made pretty light work of... Stefan's struggling to hit them, to be honest with you. Glad I'm not like a all-out archery person, or because this would be a bloody nightmare to hit these things. It's like trying to, you know, this reminds me of, if anybody's been watching Dishonored 2, my playthrough of that, which I've been streaming, like, when I come across the, like, the blood flies in that, and I'm just wildly flailing to hit them all. Lydia, could you not, Lydia? Get him. Okay, we got him. We got him, Lydia, don't worry. try out one of these dwarven spider workers. Interesting. Why are they killed from those magic anomalies then? That is interesting. I really enjoy travelling with that. I do want to try out other companions, but this is something about Lydia that she's just the ultimate, like, meme companion, isn't she? But, like, in a good way. The other day I was on Reddit and there was this post, like, on the front page of, like, about Lydia, and it was just like, yeah, even all these years later, everybody still loves Lydia. The crazy things she does. The fact that she is sworn to carry my burdens. Oh, I'm not missing fighting these things, by the way. I much prefer fighting people. I also much prefer living, so I will take some health potions. My hope is that we find some sort of machine down here which we can turn off the dwarf's law from. Maybe these are like the guardians of it or something. That's my thinking. Or maybe this is literally like the way out, and so kind of looks like that's burst through there, doesn't it? But I don't think it has. I think it's maybe meant to be like this, but okay, maybe it isn't, because I don't think they would have built a door like this. Dwarven dome, okay. Well, I mean, it'll all be safe once we get inside, but let's find out what's going on. Does it? Okay, we're detected. Holy camoli.
Ah, and here you are. I've been waiting for you, Dovahkiin.
Why does everybody know I'm the Dovahkiin? You know who I am.
Of course. To me, your memories are an open tome. Trespassed countless times against others of your kind.
Lucky guess.
And I know you have looted the corpses of those you have slain.
It's definitely not true.
Liar.
Okay, yeah, but is that all?
I know you have harvested the souls of the Dover, hoarding them, twisting them. Unnatural weapon against your enemies.
I'm sorry, but who made this guy like the judge here, calling yourself the arbiter. Right, you got me. I'm just not interested in your power.
I see the kind of person you are. My law is the only
your law, I see.
You and your kind from descending into chaos.
You mean the dwarf's law?
I mean my law. I made it because your kind would be incapable of order, of peace, without it.
So that would make you...
That makes me the arbiter. I am also the founder. I discovered this site millennia ago and the deposit of Ethereum beneath us.
Oh, that's what that stuff is.
I laid the foundations and I watched my children grow and learn and use the Ethereum to create marvels, technological wonders. Confiscated their weapons and declared my law that each and every one of my children would live in perfect order, or they would not live at all. And here I am, millennia later, still waiting for children worthy of this city. And for my patience, it seems my reward is a visit from you, Dovahkiin.
Okay.
Well, why have you traveled through time to come here? What is it you seek?
I just want to go home.
Ah, if only you could read my memories as I read yours. Very well. Ask your questions.
So you're the one killing all these people?
You flock here, your kind, like moths to a flame, driven by greed.
We're gonna have to kill him, aren't we?
Lust for power.
I just know it.
You are warned about my law, and when you disobey, and you always disobey, you force my hand, bringing death upon yourselves. So you ask if I am the one killing your kind, and I say no, you kill yourselves. I am merely the means by which you do it.
Right, okay. How long have you been down here?
2,000
wow,
years.
Wow, that's a long time.
On your terms. But time is different down here. I count time in waves, generations, civilizations. You and your kind up above are number 322.
Okay. Have you survived all this time?
You wish to be ageless, like me. In truth, time passes differently in here. It would take an eternity just to explain it to you.
What happened to the rest of the Dwemer people?
It is not my place to reveal that secret to you, Dovahkiin. But when they moved on from this world, I was left behind. You see, the energy that has sustained me all this time, it anchored me here. I could not leave this place if I wanted to.
That's all the questions I had.
So I see
No, the question I wanted to ask was, hey, how do I get out of here? It's time to put an end to your law. You come here and stained in blood. Why couldn't I just say, look, mate, how about you use your power to get me out of here? No questions asked, and I leave you alone to do your thing. And now I'm going to have to probably kill you, aren't I?
I'm not interested in hearing what you have to say.
Oh, dear.
Your presence here aggrieves me. You will die.
Oh, great. Uh-oh. Okay, maybe we want a ward, actually. No, heavy armor skill. Well, yeah, we'll take that, sure. It's a good thing we don't have, like, any extra magicka. Sure, fortify health and health. Minor magicka. Oh my god, I'm going through all my potions. Resist magic. Okay, let's get the stamina up. I'm having to cheese this a little bit, aren't I? So, here's the question, if we kill him, does everything stop? I kinda hope so. We killed him. Also, what the hell happened to Lydia? The Arbiter's helmet allows the wearer to cast continuous shock spells effortlessly. But the power is blinding. Okay. Travel back in time and show the Arbiter's helmet to him as proof of your deeds. Okay, let me just have a look down here first. Could be something interesting to pillage. It's like a lot of soul gems. Yeah, we'll take them. With him dead though, does the dwarf's law still work? Wow, look at all these soul gems. This is great. So I think that Arbiter's helmet, where is it? The Arbiter's helmet. Actually, it's not that bad, is it? Do we get to keep this? Because casting continuous shock spells. Arms to radiation, okay. What did it say? Test it out. Oh my god, we are the most powerful person on the planet. We are literally Emperor Palpatine right now, as I just pick up all these soul gems. Actually, I don't even know why I'm picking up these common ones. They're not even full or anything, so it's not really that useful. So we had to kind of jeez, that fight literally still on fire. Go, buddy. Gutted. What does he look like? Let's get him up here. I guess maybe Lydia can come in here or something. Is that the way it was? He just looks like a normal person. person. Interesting. What's at the top here? Some type of chest or button. Okay, maybe that's like the thing that powers it, but I can't press it, so. Able to set off the dwarf's law, and in doing so go and punch that Domitus guy right and square in the face. Okay, y'all. So we don't even need to go talk to the Jarl, do we?
Stop this from...
Yeah. I'll just take that circlet again. Thanks, buddy. Steal from this chest now. Ah, it's not worth it. So when that girl did say to me, like, untold riches. Oh, right, okay, whatever. Come on. When she said untold riches, it's because we could literally, like, get untold riches from this. So she actually wasn't lying. However, I don't think she quite knew what was going on. Here we go again. Hey, everybody. Let me guess.
You there. Where did you come from?
You know, we've had this conversation before.
I've never met you.
You're right. My mistake.
You're the strange one, aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
Now, are you going to tell me why it looked like you just came out of the Jarl's private lake house?
I did. There was a time portal in there which brought me here from the future.
What? Oh, I see. And you're in good company here. Lots of us will think this way.
Seriously, what is today's day?
It's the first day of last season.
What year?
I guess you hit your head pretty hard coming down the shaft, huh? It's the 194th year of the Fourth Era, of course. Look, you seem a little... you. So I'll make this nice and simple for you. Live by our laws, and we'll all get along just fine.
Sure. I ain't got time for this.
Talk to me. At least go and see your lieutenant.
I ain't got time for this, buddy. I need to get down in some tunnels. I should probably put on the helmet, the dwarven helmet, just in case. I would imagine the Arbiter's helmet does the same job. Unfortunately, oh god, am I going to have to come up against those magic anomaly things again, because I might need some potions. I wonder if they're going to be down there. Let's just see if... So he's fruit and veg. He's food. And this one is... Okay, let's see if he's got anything in here. Hello, Declan.
Hey, that armor makes you look... The best wares for you, my friend.
Oh yeah, I forgot this guy was a Scouser. Skooma, that's literally all you've got, is it? Skooma. Brilliant. Thanks a lot, mate. You're a real help. Alright, we're gonna go down there and fight those anomalies. I ain't got time for this. I wanna see the sky. I don't wanna see rock above my head. As spectacular as it is down here, and it is very spectacular, I miss that sky, even if it is full of dragons. Arbiter, we're coming for you. We are coming for you. I might try out and see if the helmet does work. Because, in the radiation, actually, because it would be quite useful against these things too. I think it does, because look, it's a nice shiny one. Look at the value of it though, 9,000. That's pretty good. I hope I do get to keep it, because it's pretty good if I can cast unlimited shock spells. Yeah. Oh, okay, there doesn't appear to be any magic anomaly things. That's good. I reckon I could jump down there, but, you know, just for the sake of it. So isn't this guy going to be surprised me walk in here and go, hey, guess what, buddy? Look, it's your helmet. That's right. I do hope I get to keep it, though. I'm very pleased that we don't have to kill those things again. Very pleased. See that light? When I look up there, nothing. It's fixed itself. I could give Lydia the other radiation helmet. So I guess she doesn't get to come into the special chamber with me. That's a shame. I really would just want to go in there when he starts doing his whole talk. Just be like, look. You recognise this? That's right. We've met before. And then he'll be all like, oh. And I'll be like, yeah, so... If you don't want to avoid what happened to you last time happening again, bluff, because I don't have enough potions, then I suggest you get me the heck out of here. Here he is. Okay. I quick save it, even though it actually does quick save when I go through the doors. Hello, Arbiter. I know, you know.
To me, yep. Your memories are an open tome.
Lucky guess.
What's this?
Hello, yep.
I see there is a helmet in your possession. Does not belong to you.
going to take it from you after I kill you.
You kill me? That is not possible. And yet, I see you speak the truth. You have come unstuck from your own time. Your presence here is unnatural. Well then, Dovahkiin, why have you returned with this grim trophy? Have you come simply to gloat of your foul deed?
You want to put a stop to the dwarf's law?
Do you comprehend what you are asking me to do? You are asking me to abandon millennia of work. The very thought of it aggrieves me. And yet, you have left me with no choice, have you? If I agree, I will destroy my life's work. But if I refuse, you will destroy me.
Yeah, I definitely will destroy you. I have loads of potions. Joaquin,
you will have your wish.
So, you'll stop all this?
I will stop. From this point forward, your kind will be free to live how they choose, in whatever chaos and squalor they create for themselves. I will destroy this Ethereum to ensure your kind can never exploit it, and you may all return to the world of man, should you wish. But I warn you, Dovahkiin, making these changes will create a paradox in time. The events that brought you here will never have taken place. What will become of you is difficult to predict, but that is the risk you have taken by interfering with the past. Now, are you ready?
I'm ready to get out of here, that's for sure.
Goodbye, Dovahkiin.
Oh my god, he nuked me. What the hell, buddy? Wait. Okay.
Hey. You startled me there. Wait. I know you.
You do?
You're... No, that can't be right. For a moment there, I thought you were... You know, the one the statue was meant to honor.
Does look a bit like me. Oh, you're the guy who... Right, okay. Your sister asked me to find you.
Cassia. Oh, I completely forgot. I asked her to wait for me at the top of the lift, and...
Lift?
I guess I got so tied up in this place that I lost track of time.
I'd funny.
I'd head back up and let her know I'm alright. Hey, do you want to come with me? We can chat along the way.
Fine.
Great. Follow me. Let's run back up, shall we? Don't want to keep my sister waiting. So, you're probably wondering what I've been doing down here. I guess it's been, what, a few days? I'll be honest. I came down here looking for a haul I could unload on the next merchant I met. I just wasn't expecting to find a thriving city.
What?
The history of this place is amazing.
Who the hell?
Did you know that up until about 7 years ago,
what
they called the Dwarves' Law? Apparently there were inscriptions warning that one person committed a crime, everyone else would pay for it. But they were all trapped in the city with no way out, so they lived in fear that someone would break the law and get them all killed. Then, one day, a strange man appeared in the city out of nowhere. They say he just walked out of the lake house, like he owned the place.
Well, yeah, that does about right.
Spectacular dwarven armor. A lot like the armor you're wearing now, actually.
Right.
A few people saw him walk into this quarry, into a field of deadly radiation, like it was nothing, like it hadn't killed people before him.
Domitus is mining.
The ground started shaking, and golden statues were collapsing, and inscriptions were crumbling all over the city, all at the same time. And the sun
underground,
which used to light up the entire cavern, bursts into flame and explodes. And strangest of all, the cavern roof opens up like the petals of a flower. And there's real sunlight for the first time.
What?
In thousands of years.
The sky.
So of course, people start wondering, did he just walk down here and single-handedly dismantle whatever was keeping the dwarves' law going?
Oh, hey, look.
Who was he? Was he still alive?
You.
The scholar goes down into the quarry to take a look. But now the whole place is empty. But all the way at the bottom, sitting alone in the darkness, is a statue of a stranger.
Let me just grab the ruby. Wow, okay. So, everything's alright. Everyone survived. I mean, I didn't really care about that, but we're back in our own time. We found the brother. I need to see this. The ceiling opened up. Oh my god. The sky. Where the hell's Lydia? What the hell happened to Lydia?
I remember you.
Go far.
Back. After all this time.
How have you been since the dwarf's law was lifted?
Can't complain, my friend. You know, not long after they executed Metallus, turns out he was behind Macy's disappearance.
Oh, really?
They made me Jarl.
Okay.
It was a bit of a shock, to be honest. But I guess they wanted someone who wasn't at all like Metallus. Jarl Galvar. Still sounds strange to me. And I guess I have you to thank for it. If you hadn't freed us from the dwarves' laws, Ulbrin could never have overthrown Metellus. So, thanks. I imagine you'll be moving on soon, but you'll always be welcome. We even kept your chambers exactly as you left them.
Well, do you think I could get bigger ones? Because it was a little bit of a... Where are you going, Golval? Oh god, do you think Lydia's trapped in the past? Bag's gonna say now. Actual real sunlight, bro. Hey, aren't you? Oh my god, it's you.
Wonderful,
have you been?
Actually, Gaia and I are still researching this place, of course. But now we get to share our research with the outside world. But I must ask, what happened down there, under the city? What did you do?
I made a dwemer call the Arbiter and convince him to lift the dwarf's law.
You convinced him, you say? Well, if it is as you say, you must be terrifyingly persuasive.
Oh, I am, don't worry.
I only wish I could have been there to see it. I can see that you have somewhere else to be. But perhaps one day, when you have the time, you'll let me record your story in my journal for posterity.
Wow, okay.
Oh, hello. Do you like my fancy new clothes?
Wait, aren't you? Yes, it is you. You came back after all this time.
I did.
Oh, it's you. I didn't think we'd ever see you again.
Well, yeah, you did. Mate, I just want to get the hell out of here. These guys, they can live their life. You can give away my house, by the way, everybody. Who's this guy?
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard.
City Guard.
Vampire hunters or something in the old fort near Riften. Might consider joining up myself.
City Guard. I'm a little bit worried about what's happened to Lydia. Not gonna lie. She's still not here. I'm a bit more worried about the fact she's got all my stuff on her. Oh my god, it's a lift.
Hey, I know who you are. It's wonderful to see you again.
Oh my god. It's a lift now. Oh, it's a shame it's not actually animated though.
There you are. Thank the gods you're alright. I kept you so long.
I know. Sorry, Cass. I've lost track of time again. It's just that stop with the time buttons. Amazing. You have to come down with me and see it for yourself. I promise. It's perfectly safe.
Well, all right. But first, let me thank our friend. Thank you so much for bringing him back in one piece. I really thought I'd lost him. I can't thank you enough.
Now, I wouldn't say you're welcome.
I promised you a reward.
Talisman, the silver top. Oh, hang on, what's this?
With me, and it's become very dear to me. I'd like you to have it.
Okay.
Thanks again. My brother and I are in your debt.
All right, okay. You're welcome. Flipping heck. That was a long one, wasn't it? What's his talisman of the silver tongue? Vendors will buy stolen items. Oh, okay. That is interesting. Why did the doors just open? The Forgotten City. Oh, okay. There you go, there's the credits. There's the cast. Oh, that's nice. I still don't know where Lydia is. Oh look, there's an actual bridge to it now. Amazing. I think Lydia's trapped in back in time. So maybe episode whatever the next one is will be going back in time to rescue Lydia. Okay. What's that? Oh shit, the bed is a dragon and I don't have Lydia with me. Oh boy. It just never ends, does it? You can get out of here, you can see this beautiful world once more. What happens? A bloody great big dragon flies over your head. Absolutely typical. Absolutely typical. Is he flying away? Yeah, he's flying away. Okay. Good. Good. You fly away, buddy. I'm happy with that. Oh, okay. So, well, I can't believe it. We made it out. I actually cannot believe that. I was super worried I was going to get trapped down there for like 15 episodes or something and I'd just be like, please let me out of here. But we got out of there. We got a sick helmet which allows us to cast shock spells continuously. A little bit overpowered if you ask me, but you know, there you go. The adjuration of an entire city. I could have stayed there and like wandered around and spoken to everybody, but I just wanted to kind of get out a little bit. Does that make sense? Like see this world again, because God, I have missed it. And I think Vass would be like exactly the same. He would be like, I just thank you very much. I'll pop back one day and say hi to everybody. But oh, sod off. Might as well just have them continuously on. Why is everybody running away from me? I mean, I admit I am probably quite fearsome. Take on the Arbiter and everything, but still. So we're gonna finish this episode up there. Next episode. Oh look, he's like run away. Should we just shoot with a bow? What do we think about there? A bit too high. Still a bit too high. A bit too low, I don't know. Oh, that hit him. Go on, Bear, off you go. Off you go, son. Ugh, okay, well. Wow, it is beautiful, isn't it? I've not seen like distances like this in such a long time. It's incredible. Ah, so, okay. What I'm going to do off camera is try and find out what the hell happened to Lydia. So till next time guys, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you then.